Hey Canucks fans, Travis Hamonic made his debut today, and we are two sleeps away from the Canucks opening up their season. I'm Clay Emo, I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter, I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCPC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club, and this is my Canucks take all in one take. It's Clay's Canucks commentary for Monday, January the 11th. This is where you get Canucks insight that's positive and timely. Oh, I got so much to talk about today, so I'll try and stay calm, try and stay focused, but there's about five or six topics I want to get through really quickly. Firstly, tonight, live stream, 10 p.m. I hope you join me. This is the most excited I've been for a live stream probably since the Canucks were playing in the playoffs, although last week's NHL 21 game was pretty fun too. But I'm debuting a new look tonight. I hope you come check it out. We have one spot left in the hockey pool, which I'll tell you about tonight. And I'm going to have a special announcement as well regarding the Canucks home opener. So a few things. So I would love for you to join me tonight at 10 p.m. on YouTube for my regular live stream, weekly live stream. And don't forget, I'm going to be doing post-game live streams at the end of, after every Canucks game this season, whenever I can. And I'm using tonight as a tune-up. Kind of consider tonight's live stream as my preseason game, if that makes sense. So you're going to try a couple things and you'll see. You'll have to come at 10 p.m. to see what I'm talking about, what I'm so excited about. Okay, let's talk about the Vancouver Canucks. A few things. The Canucks skated today. Then Travis Green did his press conference. So I want to hit on a few things really quickly from the press conference. Yes, it was a false positive yesterday. That's why they shut down camp and practices just in case. I believe there's an allusion to that it was likely a player who got a false positive. So that's a good thing. And then you don't want to jump to conclusions, but Jordie, Benn was not on the ice today, and Travis Green would not answer if that was health related or not. So not speculating, but you just kind of put two and two together, and maybe it adds up to four, and maybe it doesn't. I'm not suggesting that that's the reason for sure at all. He was fine with Mott and Gaudet fighting. Fine. He didn't say he liked it. He didn't say he didn't like it, but he recognizes that camp is competitive, and he didn't think it was too big of a deal that they scrapped on Saturday night. And Travis Hamonic, he anticipates that Hamonic wants to be in the lineup on Wednesday night. Whether that's going to happen depends on maybe how Hamonic's feeling and after maybe another practice tomorrow, and obviously all the contract gymnastics of the Canucks. They got to make sure they sign him so he's ready to go on day one, and that means maybe some LTIR money from Michael Furley needs to be freed up by that point as well. So a lot of small things, exciting things. You can tell that the Canucks season is upon us. And I want to spend the next few minutes just talking about some of the lineup, the lines and combos we saw today at practice. Now, remember, Jordie, Benn wasn't there, and there's no update on Jayce Hawryluk, who was injured by Tyler Mott. Remember, in Tyler Mott's his very eventful scrimmage on Saturday night. So keep those two players in mind. And we talked about the six guys that were waived this morning. We'll find out by tomorrow if any of them got claimed between I combined the two names. Bailey, Berchi, Erickson, Greivac, Breezeball, and Sautner. Those are the six guys, and I vlogged about that already earlier this morning. But the Canucks that were on the ice, let's talk about them. And remember, with the qualifier that Jordie, Benn likely would have been part of this group, and Jayce Hawryluk may be part of this group as well. So the forwards, let's start with them. Let's do regular strength, even strength. The Lotto line, of course. Then you had Horvat, Hoglander, and Pearson, which I'm strangely excited. No, not strangely. I'm very excited about that line. Then for the bottom six, they went back to how they ended last season. So it wasn't Vertanen and Amott surrounding Sutter. It was actually old school. So it was Gaudette between Roussel and Vertanen, and then Beagle, Sutter, Mott on the fourth line. Extra forwards today were Zach McEwen and Mark Michaelis, the center. Okay, so there's the 14 forwards. They also had eight defense. Okay, and then the goaltenders, of course, Holtby and Demko. And then they had eight defensemen, so technically they had 24 guys on the ice today. And there are four pairings. You had Edler with Myers. You had Hughes with Hamonic, which is what we expected. Then you have Hughes and Schmidt. Start again. See, I'm so excited. Let's start again. It was Edler and Schmidt, Hughes and Hamonic, and then Yolevi with Myers. That means your fourth pairing was Jack Rathbone on the left and Jalen Chatfield on the right. So no Rafferty there. And like I said, no Jordie, Benn there. So pretty interesting things. In my head, if Hawryluk was healthy, I think he's in there instead of Michaelis as the 14th forward. So you'd still have McEwen and Hawryluk as your extra forwards. And then if Benn was in there, I presume he's in there for either one of Rathbone or Chatfield. Likely Rathbone. I think Chatfield has a slightly stronger camp. But that's the thing with Benn. You don't know. He could play left side or right side, which we've talked about before. So it could be either one of Rathbone or Chatfield. Regardless, we're still one guy extra. You got to carry two forwards, two extra forwards, and extra D, or one extra forward and two extra D. And today, the Canucks had two extra forwards and two extra D. Of course, you can do that still because it's training camp, but they will have to name their roster ahead of Wednesday's game eventually. So keep that in mind. Benn on the blue line for one of Chatfield or Rathbone. Hawryluk up front for one of McEwen or likely Michaelis, unless he starts on the injured list. And there's still one guy that's got to come out of there to make your 23-man roster. Let's talk about special teams now. On power play, no surprise, the big five of Hughes up top. And then you had, of course, your Lotto line plus Bo Horvat. And there's your first unit. The second unit had Nate Schmidt up top. And then the four forwards were Virtanen, Hoglander, Pearson, and Gaudet. But what's interesting is they actually had Hoglander in the bumper spot right in the middle, flanked by Gaudet and Virtanen on the wings, and then Pearson in front of the net. So it wasn't Gaudet or Virtanen in the middle, it was Hoglander in the middle. Maybe they want to take advantage of his quick hands and his good decision making in that bumper spot. So that makes sense, that unit there. And then for the penalty killers, so they could have a perfect, you know, five and five, the two power play units, and then the two penalty killing units of four and four to make your 18 skaters. They basically used everyone except for the four extras. So on the first penalty killing unit, you had Mott and Beagle, which is the typical group from last year. And then on the blue line there, you had Edler with Hamonic, which makes sense. Remember, we keep saying that Hamonic's going to kind of take the place of Chris Tanev. So it's Edler and Tanev. Now it's Edler and Hamonic. So your first penalty killing unit again was Mott and Beagle with Edler and Hamonic. Your second penalty killing unit was Sutter with Roussel, basically taking Louis Erickson's spot. So Sutter and Roussel. And then on the blue line, you had Tyler Myers with Olli Juolevi. Now there's some thought that maybe, although it worked out perfectly to use all 18 skaters, right, and not the four extra guys, some would say that that's not Juolevi's spot once the season starts, that actually Nate Schmidt will play in that penalty killing role with, and he can play on the left side opposite of Tyler Myers, just in case they don't think Juolevi is ready to handle big penalty killing minutes. So that's something to keep an eye on for sure. And then, so that was kind of interesting too, to see those units. So the biggest takeaway there is that Hoglander in the bumper spot in the power play too, at least that's how they practice. And the biggest takeaway on penalty kill is that it's Anton Roussel taking the spot of Louis Erickson, which makes a lot of sense if you want to spread out your forwards and your forwards across power play and penalty kill. And then the only guy that might do double duty on both power play and penalty kill, according to these lineups, would be Nate Schmidt. Second power play unit, so he wouldn't get as much time as, say, Quinn Hughes on the first unit. And then that's if they think that he'd be better fit than Olli Juolevi on the second penalty killing unit. Okay, there's a lot to digest there. I know it's kind of hard to follow when I don't put up any graphics or anything, but you guys know that's my style, or that's not my style more accurately, and yet I try and articulate things to you as best I can, even though I completely messed up in the defensive units to start off this vlog. So hopefully everything's there. We will see what happens over the next day or so. This is pretty exciting. 2 days away from the start of the regular season. And I'll be doing a post-game live stream at the end of Wednesday night's game in Edmonton. And I'm doing my tune-up live stream tonight. So make sure you join me at 10 p.m. I promise, I assure you that you will not be disappointed. All right, Canucks fans, leave a comment below on anything. Any of the lineups, any of the pairings, the combos, special teams, regular strength, even strength, whatever you call it, whatever you want to talk about, leave a comment below. I will do my best to read, react, reply. Subscribe if you'd like to. Like this video if you'd like to. Stay safe, stay healthy. Take care of yourselves and take care of each other. I will see you tonight at 10 p.m. God bless and go Canucks go.